Do you bill your clients for the time that the workers spend on the job? Well, then you need to be able to record billable time activities. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. If you bill clients for time that your workers or service vendors work on a job, you will mark the time activity as billable when you record it. You must enter the rate that you are billing the client for each billable hour at the moment you enter the time activity. You will see the billable time on the unbilled time report until it is placed on an invoice and billed to the client. For example, let's imagine on May 15, Lana the lawyer did 5 billable hours for the Southwoods Road job under Kirschbaum. The rate that we bill her for is $145 per hour. And after we record this, you will see the results on the unbilled time report. So again, how many? 145 and 5 billable hours. Okay, so we click New, Single Time Activity. The date was May 15th. The name was Lana the lawyer. The customer or job that it relates to would be the Kirschbaum Southwoods Road job, and we leave the check mark billable at $145 per hour. Good. Now, we'll only put in the number 5. If she works from home, we don't need the start time, the ending time, and the amount of break time. So that would be the easier way to put it in. Now, when we click Save and Close, we can check the report called Unbilled Time, and you can see that nothing happened. Okay, click Unbilled Time, and you can see right now the only time that we recorded that's billable that we have not yet billed are these 5 hours from Lana the lawyer. We should take a quick look at the other report, the regular one, Time Activities by Employee, to see that the only one that says yes in the billable column is this May 15th, $145 per hour, $5 for Lana. And now, continuing with the same example, let's imagine on May 17th, we billed Kirschbaum for another 20% of the Southwoods Road job and added to that invoice the billable hours by Lana from May 15th. So we come here and we click New, Invoice. And I believe the date was May 17th. Yes, it was May 17th. And you're billing not just Kirschbaum, but specifically for the Southwoods Road job. Now, both the estimate and the billable time will show up here in the right panel. First, we add the estimate, and QuickBooks remembers that for this job, we usually bill 20% at a time, and we click Copy to Invoice just like we did before, and 20% of each line of the original estimate gets billed on this invoice, just like we learned. And the last step is to click Add for the billable time, and now you can see that another $725 was added to the invoice for Lana's hours. Remember, you will have to type up a description on the invoice if you feel your client needs to see that, because there's nothing that you can put on the time slip or timesheet that will carry over to this invoice when you put the billable hours on the invoice. So you'll just have to have some documentation if you want to add a description there. Now, when we click Save and Close, we can check Reports. And if you look at Unbilled Time, there's nothing because we now billed for the time that was billable. So this report should be empty. But the most important report in this case is the profit and loss by customer. When we open it and we go across to the Kirschbaum Southwoods Road job, you can see Southwoods Road has another income in the income section of the profit and loss by customer, another $725 in income, and the income account that this gets recorded into by default is this account, the account that QuickBooks created, billable hours. And this increases our income and therefore our bottom line for the Southwoods Road Kirschbaum job. Now, after checking the profit and loss by job, you probably noticed that the income from the billable hours by Lana was recorded into the default income account called billable hours. You can change the default income account for income from billable hours. Unfortunately, you cannot have more than one account for any billable hour income that you have. And that's because billable hours use a default item on the products and service list, and this default item is called hours. You cannot use any other item but this default item when you put billable hours on an invoice. Let's take a look at that item. If you come to the top right and click the cog wheel, you can come over to Products and Services, and you'll notice QuickBooks Online already included this item. This is the special magic item that you are required to use whenever you put billable hours from a time activity onto a client's invoice. Income from Bob the Builder can be a different income account that we use. So let's make another income account to put the billable hours income into, and then we'll connect the hours item to that account. You see, this way, when we bill for Bob the Builder, the income will go into that account instead of the billable hours income account. So basically, all we have to do is use this special item that QuickBooks includes by default. But if we want the income for this to go into a different account, not the default account, we click Edit. And notice, for hours, the default item that QuickBooks set up for us, the income account is the default income account billable hours. But we can click this pull down, scroll all the way up and click Add New. And this income account can be, you know, service income, and the name of it can be, what's the name there? Income from Bill the Builder. Or we can just put now we have created another income account in the chart of accounts, and after we save it, we can make sure that that is the income account that the billable hours gets recorded into, save and close. Now, let's try an example with that. May 20, Bill the Builder worked 4 hours on the Kirschbaum Southwoods Road job. We bill him at $65 per hour. And okay, so let's just do that. Let's, on May 20th, 4 hours, $65 an hour, bill the builder. So we click New, Single Time Activity, May 20th. It was Bill the Builder, Bill the Independent Builder anyway. And the customer was the Southwoods Road Kirschbaum job. It's billable to Kirschbaum at the rate of $65 an hour. And we only have to put 4 here. And again, in a case of bill, you might want to put the start time, the finish time, and the break, just so that bill can see that you recorded it properly. But since we know the summary, we're just going to put the number here. And again, when we click Save and Close, we can check the report that shows unbilled time. And right now, the only unbilled time is from Bill the Builder. But on May 22nd, a couple of days later, we're going to Bill Kirschbaum for the rest of the Southwoods Road job and add Bill's hours. So we click New, Invoice, and we know that this is May 20th, or actually it's May 22nd, whatever, and it's for the Southwoods Road job under Kirschbaum. Notice the estimate and the billable time show up in the right panel. Just like we learned before, we click Add to the Estimate and Copy to the Invoice because there's only 16% of the job left because we've done so many invoices. Now we will add Bill the Builder and his hours to this invoice, just like we did with Lana a moment ago. $260 for Bill. Save and close. And now let's click Reports, Profit and Loss by Customer. Notice we have a new income account called Bill the Builder Income. And when I scroll across, the $725, the $260 specifically for Bill the Builder went into the Bill the Builder income and not the billable hours income.